So hey guys, this is a new video and I just uploaded a video a few minutes ago, basically telling you why I can't do showcases. I will try to make this video on Hidan and kakuzu rather short. I will be answering some of the questions that I can, and it's basically speculating what I can't. But first of all, it's a Hidan and kakuzu event. As you can see here, they both get their secondary passives. What I find interesting about kakuzu getting his secondary passive is because he already has two passives which can extend his life. Basically, if he dies once, he can come back to life at least five times. You have to kill him five times, essentially. And I wonder whether or not he can do that 10 times now since he gets a secondary passive. Just kind of questions about that. Same thing, Hidan gets. I think, kakuzu, not Hidan. It's kakuzu, not Hidan, who gets all of those extra lives. Hidan, he's fairly straightforward. So if you want their passives, for Hidan, you just have to pay, what is essentially $60. But if you want kakuzu's secondary passive, it's $100. You get them through recharging. You can get a diamond kozuku, and you can get this skin at diamond. If you have them at gold before gold or silver, you will get the ring, and if you have them at gold, you will get the black tentacle, which is a tier 3 refining ring for the ring, tier 3 for the refinement material for the ring. Diamond Hidan, if you have him at diamond, you're gonna get his exclusive skin death rate, which comes with a skill. If you have him at silver, you'll get the ring. If you have him at gold, you'll get the ring, which the ring's refining material to tier 3. As you can see, these are the passive skills. Heart tearing for kakuzu, which is block deadly damage 4 times, so that means basically you die 4 times and you'll come back to life each time until the fourth time, then you die. That's what I was wondering, if he could come back to life basically 10 times, since he gets a secondary passive. Another skill for Hidan, which is the Shin and Ritual Curse. Basically, what it does, it replaces your normal attack with damage attributed by max HP to front row enemies. From what I can understand, your max HP will deal damage to the front row enemies. So if your Hidan has a max HP of 1 million, he will deal 1 million damage. Or that's how I interpret it. That will also cause him 10% damage and 10% to his recovery. It gives him taijutsu attack and HP. Basically, that's all Hidan needs. There's quite a few items that can go to tier 4 now. All of them for kakuzu and Hidan. As you can see here, you can get the religious rune. You can get 30 per day. You can get 30, which can give you the training materials for Hidan, and Hanzo fragments. Why Hanzo fragments? I have no idea. Just there as a bonus, I guess. I think that's the only thing, the religious rune that you can get. Continuous recharge will give you Akatsuki Red Jade. Mostly this is a Red Jade, which is very good in my opinion, because that means you don't have to get Hidan, you don't have to get kakuzu, you can get Kisame if you really need him. You can get Deidara. You can get other cards that do not involve basically Hidan or kakuzu. What I really find interesting about this recharge is that it gives you a lot of seal stones. Seal stones are rather rare, especially considering how you need to get them. So I mean, I'm not saying it's a great deal, but you do get Akatsuki's Red Jade and you get Seal Stones. So I mean, it's the rewards for recharging are decent. It's basically it. You can get most, if not all, of their items for right around 13K, I believe. As you can see here. Kakuzu gets 2 new items. I think they go in his feet and his earring slots. Those being the intelligent hard work and the pressure damage. Both of those can go to tier 4. Oh, my bad. You can get all of the items and the refining materials for Hidan and kakuzu at, for this event at the very least. At 11K, if you want the heart tearing, the level 105 passive, then you need to get 12K consumption. And if you want the level 105 passive for Hidan, 13K consumption. Overall, these are rather cheap rewards, I suppose. But yeah. So that's about it for when it comes to Hidan, for the event itself. I'm gonna go to YouTube now and answer questions basically from the comments in the previous video. Yeah, I'm currently uploading a video, so hang on, let me lower the volume just in case. I'm currently uploading a video. Right before this one, it's basically me ranting, so the audio may be bad on that one because of the fact that, well, I can pause the video whenever I have the ability to pause the video. The audio just shoots down in quality, basically. Why are they giving the Hanzo frags in this event? I have no idea. Maybe the next event is a Hanzo. I doubt it, to be completely honest, but it's a possibility. Can I make a showcase of the cards in my main team? If you look through my videos, you can more often than not find all of the cards that you ask about. Just go through them and probably find them. I'll probably make a playlist that's available to the public, and just showcasing all of the playlists for my card showcase basically. Let me join the clan. Just started a big fan of the videos. Give me your name, in game, and I'll pick you out and let you join. Just make sure that you're active, basically. Can you tell us if the devs respond to you? They haven't responded to me in 3 days either, and that's really frustrating. I now have enough gold to get all the items for Kakuzu. Should I wait for them or wait for another event? What do you think? Is he worth it or not? He can definitely have some decent combat power. I mean, I think he has right around six items at this point, five at the very least. So he could definitely go up to 2 million combat. But as of this point right now, to players like me, that's not a lot. But if you're mid to new player or lower level player, he really is a strong card, and I would recommend doing so. Although I would recommend getting him to diamond before you get all of his items, or if you're gonna get all of his items, make sure that you go to diamond as soon as possible just to boost up all of his combat potential. Congrats, Sir Luis, that's a big boost to your CP. Congrats, I had to drop a good amount of cash, man. With Obito in this server, it's it's always a competition with him if it comes to money, and more often than not, I can lose. Thankfully, he was a cool guy, and more or less just let me win. Or at least that's how I feel it was. And if he did, thanks. Thank you, Obito, and thanks, Sir Diaz. So jealous, man. At least I can equip him, but I can't train him up, unfortunately. Have you tried reinstalling the game? Yeah, I've tried reinstalling the game like five times. As a tip, you should do on the screen question answers. That's what I'm doing right now, man. Thanks for the tip. And yeah, hopefully I'll fix that line thing. Holy fuck, I agree for the Zetsu CP. Can you make a new ninja World War team? It's a very big possibility, but as of right now, I don't see myself doing it yet. Partly because of the stuns that Zetsu kind of does. It could be quite dangerous if it doesn't sync up with either Jiraiya's stuns or even what's his name? Itachi's stuns, because if the stun luck is broken, well, I die basically, especially at higher levels. I do. Well, another thing that you have to consider is whether or not he does a lot of damage. If he only deals, let's say, 1 million worth of damage, and that's it all, that's as high as he can go, he's most definitely not worth it. But if he can deal quite a bit of damage, he's definitely worth to put inside my team. for the Ninja World War team. Now, when it comes to CP and HP, he's just an absolute bamf. He has a stupid amount of HP, a stupid amount of CP. So I mean, in any sort of team that I need to fight against other players, a PvP team, he will definitely be a prerequisite. Should there be a new event with a trial dungeon that's moderately hard, he will definitely be in my trial, in my team for that, because he has quite a few abilities that are very useful to the team in general. He's more of a support character than anything, so I need to see whether or not he has any combat potential when I level him up, whenever that may be. It looks like that's about it for all the questions here. So yeah. As you can see, the video is being uploaded. It's pending, basically. My internet connection's stupid. So yeah, that's about it for this video. Sorry if it was lackluster and I sounded really just down, but I really am. I'm about to go to sleep. It's 8 in the morning, basically 9. I have to get to work at 4, so that's gonna be fun. Actually, I have to get to work at 2 because I lost my wallet, and yeah, it's just a bunch of fun, basically. So I have to go to sleep now. So I'll see you guys tomorrow with a new video, and thanks for watching. Hang on. Leave a like if you liked it. Leave a dislike if you don't. I appreciate you watching, and I'll see you tomorrow with a new video. Bye.